CLNS draft profiles. Patriots making their selection in the fifth round at number 177, and they drafted a guy Evan Lazar was really, really psyched about, linebacker Cameron McGrone from Michigan. And so, Evan, we had discussed possibilities of a lot of different options here. This was the wild card round where Bill Belichick, you might see a special teams ace or even possibly a place kicker. A lot of possibilities here. There were still a lot of receivers on the board. They went and got a guy that you really liked. You actually had on your big board, right? You thought was a possibility in a much earlier round, and you get him deep into the draft, 5-177. Tell us what you like.
Well, I think this is an explosive athlete. I think this is a player that can really play on all three downs potentially. He's a versatile player, can play on the line of scrimmage, line him up over the guard, over the center, have him blitz or rush the passer from that position, drop into coverage on third down. I think he can do all those things. But the main thing that you see about him is pursuit speed, sideline to sideline ability. He can go ahead and really make tackles against the run by pacing his path to the ball sideline to sideline. And I think that that's really something that the Patriots have missed at that second level of the defense. They tried to add it last year a little bit with Josh Uche and Kyle Duggar. I think McGrone's in that similar mold of a very, very good athlete. He has that ability to move laterally down the line of scrimmage and scrape at the second level, kind of slide like in a basketball stance, almost in mirror running backs, going from gap to gap. So I think this is a player that we can talk about some of the shortcomings that he has. Certainly his inexperience or lack of playing time early on at Michigan led to that inexperience. But when you watch him play last year for the Wolverines or in 2019, this is definitely a player that is a physical enough player to hold up in the box and has some athleticism and some explosive traits to play on all three downs, potentially down the road.
And now, it's a guy, another concern here is a ACL issue might have caused him to slide a little bit as well. Here in the draft, as you mentioned, not a ton of playing time as well. How do you think he fits in here with the group of linebackers the Patriots currently have? Can he vie for playing time right out of the gate?
I think he potentially could. I mean, look, they have that inside linebacker spot next to Dante Hightower. Juwan Bentley is the presumptive starter there. But I think a guy like Uche or a guy like McGrone brings a whole lot more athleticism to that spot than someone like Bentley. And are two players that are really going to be a lot more rangy from that position and have a little bit more upside in coverage as well. And McGrone, similar to Uche, when you watch him blitz or rush the passer in passing situations, I think he could be a really effective player in that regard too. So I see more of a second level impact player with a guy like Cam McGrone that can really play as an athlete in all three phases of the game and certainly be a contributor on defense. And I say all three phases because I also mean he could probably play in special teams as well. So I really like this pick. I think this is one of my favorite picks of the entire draft for the Patriots. Just a player at a good value. I mean, we'll see about the knee. Hopefully that's not the reason why he fell as far as he did and he's structurally okay in terms of his health, but everything that you see on tape, hard hitter, good closing burst, good athleticism in pursuit. I think that this is a type of linebacker that a lot of Patriots fans can get behind because we are sick and tired of seeing the Juwan Bentleys, the Landon Roberts, you know, the slow-footed backers. McGrone is nothing like that.
Yeah, you need a more athletic player at that position, and we've seen it, and it certainly isn't pretty. And those guys do, you know, the Bentleys and the Landon Roberts, they bring something to the table, but you've seen how often they get exposed because of their inability to go sideline to sideline or keep up in coverage. And McGrone, you know, kind of more fits that mold now. Guys in this room now, you've got quite a few names here in this mix. This third Michigan guy taken in the last 3 years. You think another one could potentially be a casualty here? And we talked about this during our live, but you know, there's a lot of people here. You also have Anfernee Jennings. It's going to be a pretty crowded house here in the linebacker room here when the Patriots get to training camp.
And I would assume too that Ronnie Perkins, their third round pick,
Perkins is another one, of course,
being more like a stand up outside linebacker at Oklahoma. Yeah. He was a hand in the dirt defensive end. But I think because of his size, he's about 250, 255. The Patriots are probably going to use him as a 3-4 outside linebacker. Yep. So there's a lot of bodies in that room. And I think it's clear to the Patriots that, look, John Simon last year, no offense to him, but he wasn't getting the job done. They really felt like, I think, Juwan Bentley in particular, who's coming up on his rookie contract. I think this is Juwan Bentley's fourth year in the league already, which is crazy to think about. So you have to get some players there that can be a little bit more rangy, a little bit more athletic, a little bit more versatile. You know, you got a player like Juwan Bentley or John Simon. John Simon, when he's at his best, and he was not last year, but when he's at his best, is a first and second down edge setting run defender, right? He's not going to bring anything to you in the pass rush. Well, hopefully somebody like a Ronnie Perkins or somebody like an Anthony Jennings, they could bring a little bit more pass rush. You know, we have a guy like Bentley and Roberts, who they just moved on from, obviously, too. Those guys are downhill thumping inside linebackers. Well, in steps Uche and McGrone, a little bit more athletic at that position, a little bit more versatile at that position. So I think the hope here is just looking across the board of all these guys that they've drafted over the last three drafts, really. When you think about it, the amount of bodies that they've drafted in the front seven now, Winovich, Uche, Jennings, McGrone, Ronnie Perkins, obviously Christian Barmore too, even though he's a totally different type of player, a lot of bodies in the front seven for New England. So it's clear that Bill Belichick has focused on rebuilding the front seven over the last couple of drafts.
And this was obvious. I mean, this was at the heart of their defensive issues last year. They couldn't keep up. They got pushed around. Almost every issue that they had was in the front seven. And so this had to be addressed, not just in the long term, but in the immediate. So Patriots went out and did that with several picks here, including Cameron McGrone, last person remaining on Evan Lazar's big board that he had put up on CLNS Media.
Dylan Moses is still out there, I think. I think Dylan Moses might have gotten drafted here late in the sixth or seventh round. But yeah, it was between him or Moses and McGrone. Both of those guys had some injury concerns. I think the Patriots felt a little bit better about McGrone's. It sounded like Moses might not want to play football anymore based off the injuries. It kind of taxed him so much that he was sort of tapping out. So it looks like McGrone is in a different situation than that.
Yeah, 47 on Evan Lazar's big board. Of course, you can check out all of Evan Lazar's Patriots coverage on clnsmedia.com. And for all of our draft profiles, keep it here on our YouTube channel, Patriots Press Pass. Please subscribe if you haven't already for all of our exclusive Patriots content with Evan Lazar and our whole team covering the Patriots through the draft and, of course, the rest of the offseason as we head into what we're hoping is going to be more of a normal rhythm offseason. We're not really going to have our OTAs, but we're going to get a chance to see these guys up close and personal sooner rather than later.
Hopefully early June at minicamp. Yep. That's my
exactly
hope.
Mini camp, and which would be great, something we didn't have last year. So again, first chance to get a peek and peek under the hood and see what these guys have. And Evan, of course, will be there for that. So keep it here with us. We'll have much more draft profiles on the channel too, so make sure you check those out.